Hello everyone, myself Paul Mohan, Assistant Professor of EC Department at LA Institute of Engineering Technology. Welcome to the session of Radar and Navigation Tools. So in the last session, we have started with number 3, that is the continuous wave and the frequency modulated continuous wave radar. Alright, we have seen what are the basic types of radar, that is continuous wave radar and the pulse radar. We have seen the basic components which are required in the block diagram of continuous wave radar. Apart from that, we have seen the most important principle of the doppler frequency shift, which is used in the continuous wave radar. Alright? So, in today's session, we are going to cover what are the applications of radar. Classification of radar, that means based on whether the target is moving or not. Third, we are going to briefly describe the doppler effect. Based on that, we are going to study doppler frequency. What is the application of it? And the frequency modulated continuous wave radars block light. Based on that, first we will understand from the FMCW radar that it is a stationary target and the moving target. Okay, and what are the applications of FMCW radar? Right, first of all, what are the applications of radar as we have seen in the number 1? The applications are, first is for the military purpose. Second is for the weather forecasting. Third, for airport controlling, for athlete land safely on the ground. Fourth, for the navigation purpose, to direct or to navigate user to a specific direction, whether it is a user, spacecraft, airplane, anything, to detect and measure under the earth, rather than objects which are under the earth, to detect them and to measure the earth. Alright? So, the radar is also going to be classified. The basic classification that we have done is continuous wave and pulse radar. Okay? The classification of radar includes two types. First is the primary, second is the secondary. Okay? So, primarily, the radar is going to be classified as the continuous wave radar and the pulse radar. So the pulse radar is going to be classified as two types. First type is the moving target indicator, and second type is the doppler radar. The continuous wave radar is going to be classified as modulated and unmodulated. Okay? So these are the classifications of radar. In the last session, we would see the block diagram of continuous wave radar. Alright? So, in today's session, we will cover first the doppler effect. Now, what is a doppler effect? So, the doppler effect indicates either source of oscillation or the observer of the oscillation is in the motion, as I have given one example in the last session. If one person is standing on the platform, the train is coming towards the platform. He or she is able to hear that noise loud as the train is moving towards the platform. But if that train crosses the platform, the sound of that train is going to be reduced. So the same concept is will be applied to the doppler visualization. Correct? So, let's say that if a person is moving or an object or a train is moving, we are able to hear louder or slower voice. Either the source of oscillation or the observer of the oscillation is in the motion. That is a shift in frequency. So this is the Doppler effect. And it is the basis of the continuous wave. It is the basis of the Doppler continuous wave. As we have seen, the definition of this is observable. That means that our RNA is going to transmit and receive the signal to the source and to the source. That means that the source is there, as it also is. So how is the Doppler frequency going to be calculated? There is one formula. The formula is F0 is equal to Fs integral V plus or minus V0 divided by V plus or minus V0. So this S represents source and O represents observer. O on the CZ. So FO that is equals to the source frequency in bracket or velocity of observer plus or minus the position divided by velocity of the source. Okay. And this represents the horizontal velocity. Alright? So you can say that the original velocity is in terms of sound. So we can say that how is the sound representation is positive. Of the 2 meter per second at 20 degrees Celsius. Right? So, this is the formula for the Doppler frequency. Okay? Now, secondly, this continuous wave radar. So, this continuous wave radar is and the block diagram like this that we have already discussed in the last session. That this is the continuous wave radar block diagram with its frequency response. Okay? Of the frequency, what is the frequency that is estimated in the diagram? First, we are focusing on this block diagram of the continuous wave radar. You can see from this diagram that this is a continuous wave transmitter detector, its frequency amplifier, and the unit. Now, the continuous wave transmitter is going to transmit the signal. It is having a frequency of F1 is going to be transmitted to transmitting in there. And the received echo signal, which is FO plus or minus FD. What is FD? FD represents a Doppler frequency shift. Okay? So, whether my target is moving towards the radar, my Doppler frequency is going to increase. And if that frequency, the value of that frequency is going to be reset, I can suggest my target is moving away from it. Okay? So, based on that, it is plus or minus FD, which two components are going to be applied to the detector, or it is a mixture. Okay? Mixture will produce only the Doppler frequency shift, which is going to be applied to the bit frequency amplifier. Therefore, the frequency can be independent when the target is moving towards the radar and moving away from the radar. There is going to be a new value of this indicator.
future, you are able to make individuals only indicate whether they are living in most of the reality is not displayed the rules of average. And the second one was the difference in spots, which represents the frequency versus its now, Doppler frequency for the continuous wave radar is identified as FR, that is equals to F0 or equals to F4 plus F3. The target is coming towards radar. The target is moving away from radar. FR is equals to F4 minus F3. This is the basic terms that we need to understand. Let us assume that a range of targets targets are and its unit wavelength is a lambda for certain distance. The total number of wavelength for two wave path transmission and reception path is 2r by lambda. Okay? So this one wavelength which corresponds to 2π wavelength phase. The total phase is equal to 4π r upon lambda. So the angular frequency is changed with respect to f of w is equal to 2π radian. When we have value of 5 is we have already discussed 4π r upon lambda, so we are going to differentiate this term with respect to time. So 4π lambda is a constant, so it is not going to differentiate it. So 4π lambda will be of the differentiation to be r by 2. The value of r, which is equal to r, is going to differentiate it. So 4π v r. Okay. So, I mean, W is something like omega. Omega is an angular frequency, which is called the 2π FP. That stands for angular frequency. The 2π FP is equal to 4π angular omega. The angular frequency, the final equation for the angular frequency is 2π angular upon omega. Okay. So, what are the applications? The applications of continuous wave radar is we are able to find the target bearing angle, its emission angle, and its velocity. Right? Secondly, to indicate whether my target is moving or not. Right? Third, we are able to find radial velocity of moving target. Okay. What is the velocity of the moving target? We are able to look at that. We are able to measure that. And whether an object is approaching or moving away from the radar, we are also able to calculate it. Alright?